Hey, hello. So today we do two iPad mini 2, looks like. Okay, this is iPad mini 3 and iPad mini 2 larger boards. And as you can see, the touch FPC connector is damaged. This happened very frequent and often because I think Apple does put a little bit of glue on these connectors, and also they were designed to be broken easily, actually. So if this happened to you when you do the screen replacement for iPad mini, this is what you can do. You can watch this video or you can send it to me and I can fix it. So I'm going to show you how I'm going to do that. Okay, so basically this repair stage is really two stages. You remove the FPC connector without damaging the board, and then you solder on a new FPC connector in its place. And that's pretty much it. Go. I'm right now just prepping the board, removing the plastic so it doesn't get burned doing the repair. Okay. So now, the person who sent me these boards was nice enough to remove it from the housing. I have no preference. I mean, I prefer to work on the larger board alone, but I'm just saying, like, if you're not comfortable taking it out of the housing on your own, you can leave it in it, and I will just do the repair with the housing. But this is a lot easier for me, technically, without the aluminum housing. Okay. Alright. So as you can see, I'm looking through the microscope right now, and I can see the connector is indeed very damaged. Let me zoom in for you. I'm not sure if you can see it. Okay, so the zoom is, it's okay, it's pretty decent. I'm trying to center the connector. Alright, so my first step is I want to remove it. To do that, you need to use, I don't know how other people do it, but I use the soldering alloy. So let me go grab some. We sell these on our website. On CyberDoc.lc.com, it's a desoldering alloy. You use it to desolder FPC connectors and other parts. Okay, so I'm gonna turn on my soldering station, get the soldering on and hot. Okay, you can also get the flux from our website. It's very important to use good flux for repair. It doesn't need to be wetting the solder joints, meaning like the solder has to melt in a fluid manner. Okay, so you prepare your soldering iron, clean it. I'm using the thinner that I make to clean, and you get the desoldering alloy onto the pins. so that it gets soft. Tweezers. Okay. Get that out of the way. So you basically just want to tin the tins right now. So it gets, so to do this, I prefer to use a very fine tip soldering iron to get all the pins. The most important on a stage one, taking the connector off, is that you don't want to damage the copper pad, which is actually very frail. Gets very easy damaged. So if you can, get some of this desoldering alloy onto the pad before even take out the connectors. That'll make this whole process easier. And you want to get the four corners, this retaining connections, since those copper pad doesn't do anything other than holding the connector down, you can go a little bit crazy, more aggressive. It's only because there's more solder there, so if you can get those off, it'll be easier. Okay, so that's it. Right now all the connections are soft, and we're gonna use our hot air. I find this is probably the best way to do it, in my opinion. Okay, so we got our air gun. Again, always constantly resupply a flux because the active ingredient gets burned off really quickly. Alright, so now I'm heating up the connector as a whole. And as the... you don't want the hot air pressure to be too high because there are small parts next to it that can be damaged. And then you can, once the connector is soft, can remove it like so. So that's it. The soft plastic is being removed and expose all these nice connections. Best way to remove these is use a soldering iron. So that's what I'm gonna do now. I'm gonna clean the board. The hot air part is done. Resupply the flux. Do the soldering iron ready. And also during the meantime, clean that connector off, throw in the garbage. Always it gets messy. Okay. Now we need to. I'm going to It's good to have duplicate multiple tools of the same, just in case you misplace one and you can find the other. So I'm gonna use solder wick, which you can also get it from my website or just pretty much anywhere else. Even, I guess Radio Shack went out of business. I was gonna say even Radio Shack sells them, but no more Radio Shacks. That's kinda weird. Alright, so you wanna hire iron to be hot, and again, remember, this will only work with flux. So for the solder wick to work well, it needs to transfer heat well. So we need to have flux on it. You can move back and forth, just gently, because we really don't want to break the cup of that. That's done. Let's prepare the board. Oof. Solder. I'm using 183 solder paste. So you're kind of using this like a pencil almost. Yeah, I need some new color paper. After a while, it gets dry. Okay, there we go. Some good amount of solder paste. A solder wire will work too. It's just solder paste is faster. Okay, so we got extra solder, like here. Just clean your soldering iron and soak it back up. And you can get these from my website as well. It's a debridging pin. It's pretty much just a pin. If you have a solder bridge like here that's unwanted, you can heat up the solder and use the pin as a divider and break up the solders. Too much over here. Find a way to do this. Remove the solder. Clean it off your iron. We can use a solder wick in this case, but I want to show you how to use this pin. There we go. And done. Clean up. Let's access solders. Put it off the board. And clean your soldering iron from a fresh new copper mesh. Basically, I'm tinning the pad right now. Make sure they're all nice and shiny. Okay. Every time that it gets dry, you just apply new flux. And it solves the problem. You can always wash these flux off, so don't be afraid of using them. Okay, that's it. It's pretty much done. So this one's ready. I will do the next one. And so there's two boards here. And I'll do the same thing here. And I'll solder on in the second video. Second stage. Alright, it's the same thing I'm gonna do. Soldering iron. Just gonna be soldering it all the way. Make sure your iron's clean when you start doing this. So this is what I do with a dirty iron. You see my iron tip is very dirty. Okay, so this is a thinner that I made. You can buy this. It does generate quite a bit of smoke because of the flux that's inside. And this tin inside of this tool. So when you like cling like this, twisting, you don't just tin the iron tip, you're actually sharpening it if you're doing this right. So you do it with an angle and you just twist it forward. Kind of like twisting a pencil. And as the result, you're gonna get a very clean, solid iron tip. See that? And it's sharper. So this actually helps you to keep your iron tip clean and sharp, pointy. It's pretty cool. There we go. And you just clean the dry flux off of a sponge. And can you see the difference between my iron tip? This really only works well with a copper-based alloy tip, which is what I'm using. Okay, so once your iron's clean, just get some solder bowl that's on the connector. Remember, my goal is not to remove these pins with my soldering iron. My goal is to tin the pads so it doesn't get damaged. So I only need a little bit on my tip. Very well. The other side is the harder one to do because it's location. There's so many neighboring connectors. Pretty hard not to melt the plastic when you do this. You do melt a little bit of plastic. Okay, so the next step, you want to use some iron, like before. You can probably remove this solid ball, because it's kind of doing nothing in the middle. And use it later. Okay, get hot air, not enough. Fly flux. Gently remove the plastic piece without damaging the pads. There we go.
Okay, that was it.
Yeah, a toothbrush, or in my case, chem wipe. Just wipe it. The board is clean. And again, over the excess solder over there. Let to soak it up. If there's a pin remain here, I think it burn off. I need to clean it now. Oh, alright, melted plastic. I was so close from destroying the light supply, power wire. Okay, so come on, wait for now. I throw the old connector away, clean my soldering iron. I know I'm gonna use flux. And get all the dirty solder off the board by using solder wick. So the board is nice and clean. Clean your soldering iron. This is the mess of all of the higher gun. But it's still hot. Even though I turn it off. Clean the board. I need to find a better spot. This is a weird angle. Okay, so you know what I'm doing, as I told you. Now is the time to solder the connector. So with the iPad 2 and 3, you want to be a little bit careful with the ribbon cable, because the connection in the back does have solder contact in the back, so you want to cover that before you blast over heat. iPad Mini 1 is okay because there's no connection in the back, so it's not as big as a problem. Okay, 2 and 3 on the other hand, put that into consideration. And as always, in flux. This whole process doesn't work without flux. Right now I'm refloating the board. See that, once the board is refloated and connections are secure, you can't even get this out of alignment. It will just align on its own. Okay. That was it for this one. You want to leave it to cool down a little bit just before you remove it. Remember, this ribbon connector can get damaged if you don't cover it. It's very sensitive to heat. So, like you can see, all the joints are connected, every single one of them. And just visually inspect if there's any problem. If there's a bridge somewhere on the solder pad, unbridge them with a pin. Otherwise, you're done. That was it. And now you just need to clean this with alcohol, because otherwise it's gonna get a little bit sticky. Functional, but sticky. Okay, next. Still have the hot air on. Power through. Flux. It doesn't need to be precise, it just needs to be somewhat on the spot. Cover. That's it. Wait a little bit for it to cool. And you're done. That's 2 iPad mini FPC. One is an iPad 3 model. iPad mini 2 and iPad mini 3. And finished. It took me a while, but it takes time to do it right, so. Okay, I can move on to the next repair and you can move on to the next video. Thank you for watching. See you next time.